Tadao Mori, you're head of styling for Toyota Motor Europe. What did you set out to achieve with the new Aygo Cross?
Firstly, we set up the keyword spice, fun, and X.
Actually, I can see the X in the back and the front.
Exactly. Make it more fun, emotional, and dynamic.
It also looks super agile. How did you achieve that look?
It is very important to set up a nice package. So we need a bigger, large diameter tires and set four corners. This means super short overhang. And also front view and the rear view, tire has to be sticking out. So that makes more agile and good stance. This car has to be matched in the urban situation. So that's why we designed very nicely, sophisticated surface with high lift. So this is kind of a new genre.
It's recognizably a Toyota, and I see lots of design cues from previous Toyotas. It also is a car that's been designed specifically to be European. What does that mean?
It's for Toyota design, we have a certain direction. For example, front we call a keen look. So headlamp has to be very much sharp and confident looking. So that rear combi has a nice signature. That creates a Toyota style.
The interior has been designed for this thing that is called shared interaction. Tell me what that means.
Yeah, shared interaction for the passenger and driver is very important. We don't want to divide two people. That's why instrumental panel is very much oval shape. This fits perfectly in European cities because of the size and also nice confident look. And also this biton makes more vibrant appeal in European cities.
But what about the body color, the rest of that?
We have four spice colors: chill red, fun, and daring. Juniper blue is icy cool concept. Ginger beige is warm and sophisticated. My favorite color is cardamom green, which is understated aesthetics.
Have especially a lot of space for the front passenger and the driver, but also the boot space is increased. It's about 60 liters more than the outgoing Aygo.
How will drivers experience the difference in ride compared with the previous Aygo?
Well, first of all, it's higher by 55 millimeters. You have big 18-inch wheels and higher ground clearance. It's not just done for the great SUV look, it's also for great handling and more confident ride.
Is it just a car for cities though, or can you imagine using it on the highway?
Actually, when driving on higher speeds, like on the highway, you have best-in-class NVH and stability. Because the upper body is stiffer, the suspension has to work less and it's lighter, so that you have low body roll, faster acceleration, or much lowered fuel consumption.
It also strikes me as a car that might be packed full of other features.
There are many indeed. One to mention is latest Toyota Safety Sense system with lane trace assist and adaptive cruise control. It comes at standard on all grades because we don't want to compromise on safety. It also has continuously variable transmission, which is very smooth and precisely tuned for the city driving. You won't expect actually to meet a CVT in A segment, and you won't find it except on Aygo Cross. You can go to up to 9-inch touchscreen with Toyota Smart Connect system with wireless phone connection, wireless phone charger, and ambient lighting.
How's the sound system?
We have with JBL developed especially for Aygo a JBL premium sound system with four speakers and a subwoofer, so that you definitely will enjoy your ride.
Great. Can we go and have a look?
Of course.
Because I have noticed this canvas roof, which looks really intriguing.
Yes, that's another feature we are very happy about. It's the canvas roof that is bigger and wider than on the previous Aygo, and it's just this emotional wind in the hair feature that you can enjoy in the city or on the highway. We call it Aygo Cross Air.
We brought something completely new, breaking the rules, being able to bring emotion, which is very much linked to style. We did it in the same way, not compromise on the compact size, not compromise on the practicality in a way, but connecting in a different way with the customer we were looking for.
In terms of the personality of the car, you've described it as a European car. What does that mean?
The car is conceived, is designed, is going to be manufactured in Europe for Europeans. It's the very first example in which Europeans gather thinking what this product that for the first time is 100% Toyota and only for Toyota, having in mind a specific target customer with a very clear need of living in urban cities.
Who do you think the main customers will be?
It will be a person living in a crowded urban area with a strong connection with design and looking for characteristics that are basically the characteristics of a very European profile.
The Aygo X is an A-segment car, but it's built on a B-segment platform, isn't it?
Indeed. This allows to move and to make evolve the character of the vehicle in something which is clearly closer to the B-segment in terms of driving characteristics, driving pleasure, but without losing that nimbleness, that agility, which remains standing for the category.
The other thing I notice looking at it is that it is super tall. I mean, is it a kind of crossover?
It's certainly a crossover. It is establishing a new reference for the A-class. It is what consumers, especially in urban areas, want. High hip point to sit, to have a control of the situation around and feeling extremely safe, as it happens in a real SUV.
An SUV, convertible, crossover, sounds great to me.
It is. I think when I look at the wheel dimensions against the body, the ratio, and the use, quite authentic, of the color code with this bi-tone that is going to really to break the rule of the category, is giving definitely something which is unique and authentic. We do, again, something memorable, I told you.
Go for a drive and take it home now?
This is the key, my friend.
Sounds good to me. I'm off.